हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल ऑफ यू। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट ए न्यू चैप्टर, दैट इज हेलो एल्केन्स एंड हेलो एरेन्स। नाउ इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द क्लासिफिकेशन, नोमेनक्लेचर, फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज, केमिकल सिंथेसिस, दैट इज मेथड ऑफ प्रिपरेशन, chemical reactions and polyhalogenated compounds, which are included in this chapter, right? See, most of these haloalkane compounds and haloarenes, they are synthetic compounds. They are rarely present in nature, right? And they are synthesized mostly from hydrocarbon derivatives, from hydrocarbons. By just a simple reaction, you can just displace or substitute this hydrogen atom of hydrocarbon by any of the halogen atom, where the halogen can be either chlorine, either bromine or iodine. And it just displaces hydrogen and produces the compound that is known as alkyl halide. You can also name it as haloalkane. Okay? Similarly, the same reaction can be carried out on aromatic compounds like benzene. You can just substitute this hydrogen with halogen atom. It will just displace the hydrogen and the halogen will bind on sp2 hybrid carbon of benzene. The compound produced, they are known as either aryl halide or you can say haloarene, right? So similarly, you can get both aliphatic and aromatic halogen derivatives, right? Next is, you see what are the general uses of these compounds. See, most of these compounds are clinically useful. Most of them, they are utilized in medicines. For example, one of the compound is chlorine containing antibiotic, that is chloramphenicol, which is a medicine that is used in typhoid fever, right? Which is mentioned over here. Chloramphenicol, it contains chlorine atoms. It's one of the important medicine that is used in typhoid fever, one of the infectious diseases. Similarly, other compounds like thyroxine, which is, you know, that it is a natural hormone which contains iodine, the iodine containing natural hormone thyroxine. We know that the deficiency disorder of this hormone or iodine that causes goiter, that is enlargement of this thyroid gland, which is a deficiency disease. Same way, another compound that is chloroquine, which is an important medicine used in the treatment of malaria, it is anti-malarial drug. Same way, another is halothane. Halothane is, it is an anesthetic, you can say general anesthetic used during surgery or surgical operation, which is mentioned over here, halothane, which contains bromine, chlorine and 3-fluorine atom. It is given here 3-fluorine atoms, 1-bromine and 1-chlorine. It is an alkyl halide derivative. Same way, chloroquine, that contains chlorine atom, which is shown here. Thyroxine, that is a natural iodine containing hormone. You can see the atoms of iodine. So these are some of the important uses of haloalkanes. Right? Next we see classification. That is classification of haloalkanes and haloarenes. See, there are two major classes, The first one, that is compounds containing halogen atom which is bonded on sp3 hybrid carbon atom. It's the halogen atom, either fluorine, chlorine, bromine or iodine. It can be bonded on carbon. The carbon is sp3 hybrid. Same way, second major class is the compounds in which halogen atoms are bonded on carbon atom which are sp2 hybrid, right? So these are two major classes. Even they contain subtypes. The first one here, it is alkyl halides or aryl halides, on which halogen is directly bonded on sp3 carbon. Second is allylic halides, or you can say allyl halides. Third is benzylic halides. In all these three, the X atom, the halogen atom, is directly bonded on sp3 hybrid carbon atom. Second is on sp2 hybrid carbon. There are two subtypes. One is vinylic, you can say vinyl halide. Second is aryl halide. You see that here it is mentioned that the haloalkane contains the halogen atom which is directly attached to sp3 hybrid carbon of any alkyl group, or you can say R group. Same way in haloarenes, the halogen atom is directly attached to sp2 hybrid carbon atom of any aryl group. If they are shown some examples like chlorobenzene, right? Bromobenzene, iodobenzene. Similarly, some of the derivatives of toluene like orthochlorotoluene, metachloro and parachlorotoluene. Here you can see that all the carbon atoms of benzene ring are sp2 hybrid. On this sp2 hybrid carbon, the halogen atom is directly attached, right? Here it is shown classification of the halogen compounds on the basis of number of halogen atoms, means the how many number of halogen atoms are attached to the hydrocarbon part of organic compound. So they can be classified as monohaloalkane. Monohalo means only single halogen is attached. Same with dihaloalkane, which contains two halogen atoms, as well as trihaloalkane, which contains three halogen atoms. This is for aliphatic, so you can see here alkane is mentioned. Same way in aromatic, you can say monohaloarene, is halogen on aromatic ring. It is similar, dihaloarene and trihaloarene, which contains three halogen atoms. Right? So mono, di, tri, you can introduce the prefix. And if there are more halogen, you can just name them as polyhalogenated compounds. Here we will see the classification based on the compounds containing sp3 carbon and halogen bond. Here it is mentioned first type is alkyl halides or haloalkanes. In this, halogen is directly attached on the R group, that is alkyl group, and there is directly attachment of halogen. Here the general formula is given, or you can say homologous series. You can represent as CN H2N plus 1X, where N is number of carbon atoms. They can be further also classified into three types, that is primary, secondary and tertiary alkyl halides. Primary, as you know, that when there is single alkyl group attached to the carbon atom, that is known as primary. If there are two alkyl groups on carbon, and on that carbon halogen is attached, so it is known as secondary. And third one is tertiary, on which three alkyl groups are present on the carbon atom, Second type, that is allylic halide, and here also the halogen atom is directly attached to sp3 hybrid carbon, but in this there is one specific that halogen where it is bonded to sp3 hybrid carbon, adjacent there must be carbon carbon double bond, or you can say nearby carbon must be sp2 hybrid, which is shown here. The halogen is bonded, the carbon, this carbon is sp3 hybrid, but on the adjacent side the nearest carbon must be sp2, or you can say there must be a carbon carbon double bond on the next carbon, right? So that is classified as allylic halide. And the third subtype is benzylic halide. So in this halogen, again it is attached compulsorily on sp3 hybrid carbon, and that carbon atom is directly linked with benzene ring. Means on aromatic ring there must be a carbon atom, and on that halogen is attached. So that type of compounds are known as benzylic halide. Here it is mentioned that the compounds in which the halogen atom is bonded to an sp3 carbon atom, which is next to the an aromatic ring, right? So they are classified as benzylic, and even in that they can have subtypes like primary, secondary, and tertiary. Means there is only one alkyl or aryl group on carbon. Here there are two R groups on that central carbon atom. The same way it can be primary, secondary, as well as tertiary in benzylic halides. Next classification is compounds containing sp2 carbon and halogen bond. We'll see that. That is compounds containing sp2 carbon and halogen bond. In that there are two subtypes. In that first is vinylic halides. In this you can see the halogen atom is directly bonded to the carbon, which is sp2 hybrid, or you can say halogen is bonded to carbon of one of the carbon of carbon carbon double bond, which is present. Similarly, it can be in alicyclic. Here in alicyclic ring there is double bond, and the same carbon halogen atom is attached. So they are named as vinylic halides, right? See, here it is mentioned that what is the difference between vinylic halide and aryl halide. It is shown that in both you can see the carbon atoms are sp2 hybrid in both of these types of compound, but here it is a type of alkene derivative. It is vinylic in nature, or you can say it is alkene, while here it is an aromatic ring on which halogen is present. Second important difference is reactions with base and with Bronsted acid will often occur with vinylic halides, means they can react with either bases or either with acid, but there is no such reaction, or they are, you can say they are less reactive as compared to vinylic halide. That is one of the important difference. See, it is mentioned over here that in aryl halides the halogen is bonded on the carbon, which is sp2 hybrid, but here it is bonded directly on the aromatic ring, on the benzene ring the halogen is attached, right? So they are classified as aryl halides. Here one of the note is mentioned that aryl halides widely occur in nature. Mostly they commonly they are produced by marine organisms, right, that utilizes chlorine, chlorides, as well as bromides, which are present in the sea water, right? Is one of the note which is mentioned. So now Next, we'll study the method of nomenclature that we'll see in the next lecture.